Hi guys, and welcome back to today's video. I hope you guys are doing great. Today's video is actually a collab with Nina from Everyday Blessings. I will have her channel linked down below, so be sure to go check that out, as well as a playlist of other mamas kind of sharing other unschooling things, whether it be how they unschool, what it means to them, how they do it, and probably some great advice. And I cannot wait to watch the playlist and get some other tips and tricks from other mamas who probably have way more experience than I do. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. And as always, if you do, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and let's get into it. I wanted to start off today's video by first kind of telling you what unschooling means to me. And this is just something, I'm not giving you a, to buy the book definition of unschooling. This is just kind of what I've taken as it to be. But it is the opposite of the traditional school. It is not a classroom setting where the teacher will tell the child what they will learn. And it's not the teacher telling the child how they will learn it, what they will do to get that into their brains. But it is the opposite of that. It is the teacher actually learning their students. It's actually, you know, me as the parent studying my children almost, and then them kind of letting me know what they're interested in, and then me providing them the materials to almost kind of learn it by themselves and to teach themselves. One of my favorite Charlotte Mason quotes, and I'm not going to be able to quote it verbatim because that's just my memory, but I love that she says that children are born with all the curiosity that they will ever need. And it is really up to us as parents to make sure that that curiosity doesn't die. And I feel like when kiddos, especially when they're little, as mine are, preschool, kindergartner age, if they were stuck in a schoolroom and they were told what to learn and how to learn it, instead of really going after what they were interested in, I feel like their love of learning would be just kind of stomped on. And I feel like it would not be exciting, it would just be mundane, and they would do it because the teacher told them to do it. It's not because they're actually interested in learning. So unschooling is definitely something that I am really excited about actually diving in head first this coming school year, because at the end of this past school, or really honestly the last few months here, I've really been getting into more unschooling things, doing more unit studies, things like that, depending on what the kiddos are interested in. And it's a night and day difference. It really is. And it's really cool to see how they went from kind of taking that 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. and they only thought they had to learn then, but now it's like they can learn all day and they don't even realize they're doing school. And it's been really, really, really fun, and I'm looking forward to what the school year brings. So the next thing is why we chose to unschool our kids. And for me, I think my number one reason, this is gonna like go back to like last year when my little one, my oldest was just in preschool, and he made some type of a comment or was complaining about having to do a school lesson, or it wasn't even a school lesson, I think it might have just been like some hands-on activity or something like that in the afternoon, but it was after our typical like 9 to 12 school morning. And so he was like, well, I don't have to do that, Mom, because it's not school time. Like, it's not learning time. And I think in that moment, I realized that I was doing schooling wrong, because in my mind and in my heart, I wanted our, you know, another Charlotte Mason quote, where education is an atmosphere, it's a discipline, and it's a whole life. And I was really saddened because that's what I wanted to provide for my kids. I just didn't realize I was going about it the whole wrong way. Like, they're so little, they don't need the structure of the books and like all that and everything. Even when they get a little bit older, I don't see how that would be super beneficial. Apart from, you know, our language arts and math and, you know, things like that. But everything else, I don't know, like the entire life is learning itself. And when I realized that he said like, oh, I don't have to learn, it's not school time, I was like, oh, that's not the atmosphere I wanted, like I said before. So I decided to kind of like look into unschooling more. And that's when we kind of stepped back from a little bit of the mundane and the sheet work. And we just decided to learn, I think at the time when we decided to step back, he was into insects and stuff. So we did insect unit study. Then he went to learn about the ocean. So we did an ocean unit study and a human body study. And just all these unit studies. And before he knew it, he was looking at ocean books all day long. He was doing human anatomy things all day long. So it went from just having like the morning sheet work to he was just into this all day long. So he didn't realize he was actually learning all day. And I want to create, especially this coming school year, an even bigger atmosphere of learning for them, and to provide them the materials and the opportunities to just dive into whatever it is that they're interested in, and just to really see them grow and thrive off of that. And yeah, I'm I'm really, really excited and I can't wait to start the new school year. And even though I'm like really struggling to finish this year out strong, I think it's like the homeschool burnout where like at the end of the year, you're like, okay, let's get in. But yeah, so I am excited though to kind of dive into all of our new materials and to have a more open mind this time around this coming year because they are so little. And I feel like, you know, once we create the atmosphere when they're this young, then they'll have a love for learning the rest of their life, hopefully. That's my prayer anyway. So the last thing that I did want to talk about is what homeschooling actually looks like for our family as far as like what we actually do with it and how we do it and everything like that. But yeah, what that looks like for us is we normally get up in the morning, and this is our typical routine when, you know, before we started our house remodel. But what we typically do is we get up in the morning, we have breakfast together, and hi, honey. We do have breakfast together, and then after that, that's normally when we do our actual like formal stuff, and that is, you know, our reading lesson and our math, and that's about it as far as our structured school goes, because those are really the only two necessities, and then our handwriting. And handwriting can look like a lot of different things. We do, they love doing chalk, so we do that a lot. They use chalk either outside when it's nice out, so we'll do it there. Or we have chalkboards down in our basement that we use. We have dry erase boards. We have pencils, like crayons, paint, whatever they choose, that's what we do. And so sometimes that looks like just basic, just like pencils and their paper. And sometimes they like just doing it original like that. But then most of the time they do like using their chalk and the paint and everything like that. And that's what I mean when with homeschooling, you can kind of take handwriting and you can do 10 different things with it. You don't have to just say, okay, here's the paper, here's your sheet, here's your pencil, here you go. So yeah, you can do any way you like. So that's kind of what we do for handwriting. And like I said, for math is like the manipulative games. And I will tell the kids story problems. So I'll say, okay, so Johnny had 3 apples and his friend gave him another like half dozen, so 6. And so they'll add it up and then they'll take their little pieces and count it out. And they'll say, oh, it's 9 or whatever. Yeah, so they like doing math that way. And then for our human anatomy study, we've been really, really diving into that. We kind of switched back and forth from doing like our insect study to human anatomy, depending on what they feel like learning. And that's the joy of homeschooling, is it's actually a joy to learn. And that has been really refreshing. It's no longer just like boring and, oh, we have to do it because the instruction manual said we had to learn that day. It can just be whatever it is they're interested in, and I love that. And so we've been doing that, and then in the afternoons, if they want to watch a video, whether it be about the human body or about the ocean or whatever it is they want to learn about, we'll do either documentaries, we'll do it. There's so many incredible resources on YouTube as well, as far as educational content goes. So we'll normally do that in like the late afternoon. And then in the evening time, like they can still do books, and that's when we do our floor puzzles and our games together as a family. So even like I shared in my last game video, I'll link it up above or down below for you to go check out. But you'll see all the games are super educational, the puzzles, they're learning geography, and it's just incredible like how much learning happens without the actual structure of a school. It's amazing. I've been loving the homeschooling method. It is what's working really, really well for our family, and I know, I definitely know it's not for everybody, but it is why our kids are just thriving. They are just loving it. They love learning. They love being home. They love just everything about it, and that makes me happy. So when the kids are happy and thriving, I have a lot of peace and contentment in that when I know that they are also peaceful and contented as well, but if that makes sense. But yeah, I hope you guys did enjoy today's video, and I would also encourage you, maybe if your kiddos are not wanting to do school or are struggling with finding the motivation to like sit down and have school time, to look into this method, because it is child-led, and you might find that, you know, when you go with what your kids are interested in, how much they enjoy learning and they love it. But yeah, I hope you guys have a great rest of your week. Stay safe and God bless. I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.